I'm Math Dad.
I'm Science Mom.
Today we're talking all about fractions. So how to recognize them, how to estimate them, what they mean.
And don't forget, in the description there is a link to a worksheet you can use as you go through this video. And you can also check out our Fraction Ninja Bootcamp.
Okay, our first problem asks us to shade 2/3 of each shape. But what does that even mean? Let's remind ourselves, what is a fraction? So when we write 2 divided by 3, that is the same as saying 2 divided by 3.
That means the same thing.
2/3, 2 divided by 3. I even said them both the same out loud. Or sometimes we would actually write that as 2, and then we put the slash there, like I've done up in the question. And that means the same thing. It just allows us to do it in less space. So 2 divided by 3 means so 2 parts out of 3. And one could try long division and decimals and things, but let's keep it simple for today. So when we look at this bottom number, the 3, that tells us how many slices we're going to be making. So I've got my pizza here. So slicing up my pizza into 3 equal pieces. Didn't really succeed.
That was pretty close, Math Dad.
Yeah, okay. So 3 equal pieces. Oh no, when it comes to pizza slices, you've got to get it right. Otherwise, one kid will complain, he got more than me. Okay, so that tells us the number of slices, the 3, and the 2 just tells us how many we're actually going to include. So I'm going to shade 2 out of the 3 slices, and voila, I have shaded 2/3 of the shape.
So that's 2/3 of a pizza right there.
2/3 of a pizza. Or if on this rectangle, well, I need to chop it into 3 pieces, and I need to shade 2 of them. And they should be equal size pieces. You may have to use your imagination a little bit, but I could shade this one. And just to be creative, I'm going to shade this one.
Ooh, they don't have to be touching.
No, I shaded 2 parts out of 3. That was 2/3. So with other fractions, the top and bottom values will change, but they're going to carry the same meaning. We can always come back to this pizza slice idea. And we even have a fancy name here for these. This 2 is the numerator.
Ooh.
Sounds kind of like numberator.
It eats the numbers. Numerator.
Numerator.
Numerator on right. The top.
Divided by 3. Well, that 3 we call the
denominator.
Good job. I knew you'd remember that one, Science Mom.
I do remember this. All and right. You know an easy way to remember that numerator is on top and denominator is on bottom?
No. What's an easy way?
It's numerator divided by denominator, so no dirty dogs. Nobody likes a dirty dog. We want our dogs to be clean.
No dirty dogs. Where do you get these things? No dirty dogs. Numerator divided by denominator.
Yep.
Okay. This next challenge, we want to label the fractions on the number line. So in the past, when we've looked at number lines, we've seen numbers like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, just that are counting numbers. But now, we're looking at numbers between those nice round hole numbers.
Between 0 and 1.
So let's start with 1/4. So the 1 on top is the numerator. The 4 on bottom is the denominator. The 4 tells us how many pieces we need to slice it into.
Ooh.
So I've got from 0 to 1, I'm going to slice that into 4 pieces. So by cutting it in half, first of all, and then I'll cut each of those halves into halves, and yeah, about even slices. Okay, when I look at it, well, this one's 1 part out of 4, then 2 parts out of 4, 3 parts out of 4, and I could even do the 4 divided by 4, 4/4
equals 1.
Is 1. What about the other end?
0/4 is 0.
0/4 is 0. So this question specifically said identify 1/4, so it's right about there on the number line.
Very nice.
Okay, Science Mom, can you do 3/5?
My turn. So I know that I just need to divide it into 5 equal pieces. So I'm going to eyeball it and hopefully get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, that doesn't look very good. Let me try again.
It is rather tricky to get it anywhere near accurate. You kind of have to use your imagination sometimes.
Again, one more try.
Come on, you could do it, Science Mom. That's pretty good.
That's obviously, they're not exactly equal, but they're close. And this would be 1/5. That would be 2/5.
Good.
3/5. 4/5. 5/5.
Okay.
And here would be 0/5.
I like
it. So I'm supposed to identify 3/5. That is right here.
Nicely done. And then our last question is 5/8. So you cut it in half, you cut those in half, and then you cut them in half again. Is that what I just saw?
Yep, that's what I did. And that should give me roughly equal pieces.
Okay.
And I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here is 5/8.
Oh, I like that. So you were able to identify the right location without even needing to label everything.
Yep.
Okay, that's kind of clever. So the 8 told you how many pieces. The 5 told you how many tick marks to go over.
That's right.
Very nice. What fraction of this figure is shaded? Got a rectangle with some squares inside it.
So we just need to count up the boxes. I've got 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I know that 5 times 3 is 15, so there are 15 total boxes.
Cool.
And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 of those boxes are shaded. So 4/15.
4 out of 15 are shaded, so 4/15 of the whole figure is shaded. I like it. Ooh, how many pizzas are below?
How many pizzas? Well, we have 2 whole pizzas, and then we have part of a pizza, and that looks like a half to me, so I'm going to say 2.5 pizzas.
2.5 pizzas. How did she do that? She just eyeballed it so fast, but I like it. It's absolutely true. There were 2 pizzas and half of a pizza. So altogether, 2.5. Or there's another way of looking at this problem. So we could slice these guys in half so that now we have halves of pizzas. How many halves of pizzas do we have?
There are 5 in total.
That's right. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we could write that as 5 halves of a pizza, or 2.5.
And it's the same.
Those two numbers are exactly the same. They're entirely equivalent. They mean the same thing to us. Here's a riddle for you, Science Mom. Why would a man living in New York not be buried in Chicago?
I don't know.
It's because he's living still. We don't bury people who are living.
Thank goodness.
I tell you loved my joke.
Sorry.
All right. How many squares are shaded below? So it looks like I had 4 big squares, but not all of them are shaded.
So we have 3 and most of a 4th. So 3 and some fraction. And to figure out what fraction that is, I think it would be helpful to cut my square up into smaller pieces.
Ooh, I like it.
So if I go like this, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces, and 3 out of those 4 are shaded. So I have 3 3/4.
Excellent. So we've written it as a mixed number, got a fractional part and a whole number part. What about if we wanted to write it just as a fraction?
So the same way we did with the pizzas, we can divide all of these, and then we just need to count them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. There are 15 in total. Oops, sorry, that's a little dark. 15 in total. And how big was the piece that we were looking at? It was a fourth.
It was.
So 15/4.
So 15/4 is equal to 3 3/4. So either way would be a perfectly good answer. In this case, I would probably say, it's 3 3/4 pizzas, and that would make the most sense.
Square but pizzas?
Everything's pizza. You put pepperoni on them. You're making me hungry, Science Mom. Oh. Okay, now we want to slice this line segment at 2/5. The question is, what would the lengths of the 2 line segments be?
If we slice it in 2/5, yep. We're cutting it in half. We want to know where to cut it.
Yeah, so we've got a number line here, but it's a vertically oriented number line. And, ooh, I like this.
So I'm trying to divide it into 5 equal pieces. That looks close to being right, except this interval is a little too long. Let me try again. So we want to divide it into 5 equal pieces. I'm just going to eyeball it, and I think...
That's pretty good.
That's okay. And the 2 mark is about right there. That's my guess for 2/5.
Okay.
What do you think, Math Dad?
Yeah, you mean you drew it a little bit below...
I did, because I thought my first 2 intervals were a little big.
Oh, you were trying to correct. Okay. Yeah, but I mean, that's essentially what you do, though. Yeah, you'd say, here's 1/5, 2/5, 3/5, 4/5, trying to chop them into equal pieces. And you're saying that the 2/5 line was right there.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's one line segment. So that one's 2/5. What's the other piece going to be?
3/5.
Because you pulled out your samurai sword, you cut it in half. Ooh, I like that. So you're saying that would be 3/5,
mm-hmm.
the top half. And how did you get that?
Because 3 + 2 = 5. And if I divide this line into 5 equal segments, then this fraction needs to equal, plus this fraction needs to equal 5/5.
Yeah, so you're really just counting, right? You're saying, oh, there are 2 parts down there, there are 3 parts up top, and all together, that does account for the entire line.
Yep.
So now, Science Mom, it's time for us to play Fraction Ninja.
Fraction Ninja.
Let's do this. All right, Science Mom, we've got a samurai here ready to fend off the ninjas who are attacking, and there's only one way to succeed. You've got to pull out your samurai sword and slice with exactness. So we have our vertically oriented number line, 0 to 1.
And I have to cut it where
the target says.
The target is.
So it says 3/4 is your target for your first one. And anytime you touch that line, that's going to count as a swing. But you can actually draw wherever you'd like.
So I can try and mark.
Yeah, that's right.
4th there. That looks like 4 equal parts. So...
It was a really well done
one. I was super close. And then another attack comes. 2/8.
2/8. Where is 2/8? Oh my goodness. You nailed that one.
I've never been that close. 2 out of 2. Oh, that's 1. That's easy. Look how well I'm doing. And 0 out of 5. That's 0. That's also easy.
Only if you hit the target.
2 out of 5. I was a little too hasty.
Nice.
2/5, I'm going to say about there. Ooh, yep.
And you'll notice that the answers are actually showing up there, so you can see how far off you were.
Yeah, I should have been a little higher.
Yep.
What happens, Math Dad? This says 4 out of 4. Huh? What if I make a mistake and I'm rushing, and I think it says 1 out of 4?
Then you just lost most of your life right there. Your health bar just dropped.
Oh my goodness. All right. So I better be more careful.
You'd better be
5,
more careful.
5 out of 7, that's going to be up here.
Very nice.
Look 8 out of 8, that's 1. 1 out of 3, about right there. Oh, I'm doing so well. This is exciting.
She's good.
Ooh, I wasn't quite so close there. 8. And I think this might be my last one.
And, oh, you made it to 12.
I made it to 12. What's your record, Math Dad?
69.
Whoa. Yeah.
The most I've ever defeated was 69. So... if you can make 70, you'll have beaten Math Dad.
Nice.
So look down in the description for that link and dive in and give these problems a try, because being able to estimate the values of fractions just by eyeballing them will be an important skill and will help you to develop number sense.
Special thank you to our patrons who make this video possible. If you'd like to join us, you can become a patron by going to patreon.com/sciencemom.
Work hard, grow smart, and we'll see you next time.